The world is Ishwara.
Okay.
Okay, world. Ishwara appears as the world.
Yeah.
Right? Okay, so Rajogana and Tamogana appears as the objects of the world. Sattoguna appears as the intellective jiva.
All the intellects in these forms.
Yeah, now all this is all the
yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes. There are no separate forms. That's what you are saying. So he has Mahat. He has a universal. He has the intellect. There is a universal intellect called Mahat Tattva, and that uses the Rajas and Tamas for the creation purpose.
So now there is no creation as such in our concept. Mm. There is it's only for words.
Yeah.
Reality, Ishwara is the universe.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm. When you go to pure aware, when you go to Chidabhasa, there is no concept of the world. It's called Asmita. In yoga shastra, it's called Asmita.
Okay.
And I am feeling, pure I am feeling, which means there is no attachment to I am the body, I am the mind. There is no tamas and rajas.
Then there should not be no concept of rajas and tamas also, right? When what there is no creation.
Naya, no creation as we call as somebody sat and created a world.
Yeah. It's not.
The Ishwara appears as the world.
Yes.
For Ishwara, world and Ishwara are not separate.
Okay.
From Ishwara's point of view.
Yeah.
So, because being not separate from the world, he doesn't know individual objects. Correct? There is no individual objects.
Yes.
So, to experience the individual object, it has to take the, he has to, the body has to appear. Individual body has to appear.
Yes.
Otherwise, individual world cannot appear.
Yeah.
So, that body is you. Your body. Your intellect. In that your intellect, there is a manifestation of consciousness. No, Chidabhasa is there. Ishwara continues to be there.
Yes.
But the projection happens because of Rajas and Tamas. So that's why objects appear.
Yes.
Okay. From Ishwara's point of view, he cannot separate out the world from him.
He is the world.
Then he cannot say that's okay. There's a tree, there's a sun, there's a moon. He cannot say that.
Then in him only the forms, I am created in him only, right?
So, to experience the world, Ishwara has to take the form of a Jiva and Jagat.
Both, yeah.
Okay? So, without that, if you don't take an individual viewpoint, you cannot see the world. There's no tree, there's no forest, nothing you can see. Separation is required.
Yeah.
And the separation comes because of Rajas and Tamas Guna.
Yeah.
Right? So now this Rajas and Tamas create the feeling of I am separate from the world.
Yes.
So the moment I am separate from the world is created. Okay. So there is experience of the world. Correct?
Yeah.
Ishwara has no experience of the world because he is the world.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But Ishwara has to experience the world in the form of Jiva.
Yes.
So that's where Rajas and Tamas comes into play.
And also sattva.
Yeah.
Sattva doesn't create separation, right?
No. Sattva forms the reflecting surface for the conscious, universal. Sattva for the Chidabhasa.
Yeah.
Okay. Without sattva guna, there is no Chidabhasa. Right?
Yeah.
So sattva guna forms the basis for Chidabhasa.
Yeah.
Then rajoguna and tamoguna forms the basis for objective experience, separation.
Objective experience, yeah.
Right, from Ishwara point of view, Ishwara has no ignorance, which means he has no separation from anything.
Yes.
If he has no separation from anything, there is no experience. He is the world.
Yeah.
Correct? So now, how is he is the world? That you can get only when you stay in Chidabhasa. I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am Chidabhasa. So then you are the world. You are one with the world. The oneness with the world is there.
Okay.
Now you go one step beyond, then you become Sakshi, right? The world becomes a dream.
Okay.
World is
so
not
I
beyond.
Have gone beyond Ishwara now, right?
You have gone beyond
Ishwara.
Ishwara. Okay. It's called Sakshi.
Yeah.
Sakshi or witness.
Yeah.
I'm speaking of not individual Sakshi, universal.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah.
Okay. So universal Sakshi doesn't see anything. Universal Sakshi just gives light.
Yeah.
Right?
Hmm.
And that Sakshi is Brahman. So you have to go one step further.
Yes. That Sakshi is Brahman. Yes. So I'm going beyond the Sakshi also, the witnessing also.
Yeah, witnessing, there's a witnessed, which is the world.
Okay.
Which is the Maya.
Yeah.
Okay. Hmm. So one step beyond that is the reality. So all the while nothing has happened to the reality. Only the movies are appearing and disappearing. And reality or Brahman doesn't even see the movies.
Yeah, just the screen, that's all. So it's not aware that a movie is being projected on the screen.
Correct. Now this guy has come out with another answer, another question.